Welcome. In this edition, we would talk about Kurukshetra May 2019, where we would be focusing only on organic farming, a very, very important topic, not only for your prelims, but also for your mains. For prelims, you have two things that are very, very important here, and those are the Inhana organic farming technology and the concept of aquaponics. So aquaponics is a concept where you are trying to grow or combine fishing with a soilless culture. So growing plants in water along with the fish culture is what is known as aquaponics. Inhana organic farming technology is a unique technology developed by Dr. P. Das Vishwas, and it talks about ecological and economically sustainable crop production, which could come up in a time-bound manner. So there, it has been developed on the principle of element energy activation, which is EEA. So the principle of EEA, element energy activation, is the key concept under Inhana organic farming technology. Those two concepts are very, very important for your prelims examination. Now coming on to the basics of the organic farming. As we say organic, that is getting back to the nature. So not using chemical fertilizers, pesticides is the core idea. So we focus on four things under organic farming. The first is rotating the crops using green manure. So this could be plant leaf or waste material, biological pest control which is used, and vermicomposting, which are basically the mix of kitchen waste and other vegetable waste, where you have different worms that are being used to create a vermicompost. Okay, so that's the sole idea. Now this organic farming can lead to sustainable development. In 2016, Sikkim became the first state in India to be declared as an organic state. The idea is production in such a way that soil, ecosystem and people are sustainable. It provides high nutrient food to human beings and animals. And most commonly, you have four principles that are applied. The principle of health, ecology, fairness and care. So these are the four principles that are applied in organic farming. Principle of health, ecology, fairness and care. We aim at maintaining a long-term fertility of the soil, controlling all kind of pests through biological means, providing a crop nutrient proportion, excessive management of livestock, good impact on the environment, sustainable development, and focusing on the reduction of the carbon dioxide emissions into the atmosphere, which it is believed could be reduced to from 40% to 60%, and therefore we could mitigate the problems of climate change. The next is, under this we not only focus on crop rotation, we also talk about crop residue, manure. So manure is the organic matter which is derived only from the biological sources. Those could be plant, animal or human residues, and this manure could be further classified as bulky or concentrated. So bulky is the farmyard manure, which is mainly the compost and the green manure, and then you have concentrated organic manure, which is mainly from the raw materials of animal or plant origin. Now these are the various organic farming techniques, as we have already discussed, are very, very important. The other kind of waste that could be processed and used is the industrial waste, the municipal and the sewage waste. Biopesticide, as we said, focus on the use of biological waste to control the pests. Similarly, biofertilizers are the fertilizers which have the capability of naturally fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Vermicomposting, as already discussed. So some of the important facts is, country with the highest organic share is Liechtenstein. So it has the highest area under organic farming. If we look on to the world per capita consumption, it is 12.2 euros. However, in India, it is only 0.2 euros for organic food that is consumed. So definitely it needs to be increased. In terms of area, Madhya Pradesh is the largest area which has been producing organic food. Natural resource management and biodiversity has been very, very important. So soil fertility, stability is very important. For the topsoil, we talk about earthworms, protozoa, arthropod that could be contained. We are trying to suppress soil-borne pathogens, prevent any kind of soil erosion that is there. Also, we talk about the bacterial and the fungal abundance that is there. higher earthworms could be a kind of organic, could be part of organic farming. Similarly, we are talking about higher species of carbide and epigeal spider. There are numerous studies where you have wood mouse, common shrew as some of the common animals which are being used. Similarly, we have carbon sequestration. Now, carbon sequestration we have covered a separate lecture, so you can just go to that lecture and understand that in detail. The idea is the concept of carbon storage. So once we start doing carbon storage, we can mitigate the harmful impacts of carbon or excess carbon into the atmosphere. We are trying to reduce the energy dependence because we are not using synthetic fertilizers. We are using conventional form of fertilizers. Cattle manure, legumes have been used. So we are reducing the use of energy in organic farming. We are also focusing on cost benefit analysis. So we have various examples from Shimoga and Bhadravati in Karnataka, where cost and cost benefit analysis of rice production has been done, and this shows that the organic cultivation is about 21% lower than the other conventional farming. Water quality has been a significant issue, so irrigation of the crops with wastewater may cause heavy metal accumulation, so it is hazardous, which needs to be checked. Similarly, fixation of nitrogen is very, very important. We have seen heavy metal which is accumulated mainly in eggplant, tomato, spinach, carrot. So all those depositions could be checked by use of organic farming, and there is a kind of farm management practices that must be applied. The next is the potentials for new technologies in organic farming. So we focus on two things: climate change and hygienic food security, which are some of the biggest issues worldwide. So the present state of organic farming, India has a very good position among the 172 nations of the world with a very huge amount of organic procedure process under cultivation. We are also ranked 11 in terms of organic product export in 2015. There are numerous challenges in organic farming that are seen. We have already talked about the Inhana rational farming technology developed by Dr. P. Viswas, which uses EEA principle, that is element energy activation. The idea is to generate economically and ecologically sustainable crop production. We are also talking about less farmer participation when it comes to larger demonstration, but organic farming requires a lot of major manpower that should be part of it. So that is one of the major challenges that we focus on. The next is the marketing and the branding. So Madhya Pradesh, as we said, is the largest producer of organic content, followed by Maharashtra, Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan. You have national program on organic production that was implemented to give more certification standards for organic production. We have a global farmland which has been increased. America is considered as the largest market for organic produce, followed by Germany and France. However, in India, we are trying to slowly and gradually increase the organic market. Red Otter Farm in Uttarakhand is a unique example, where we already talked about aquaponics, where you have fish cultivation along with soilless plants that are grown. Ecozine in Pune is again a unique startup, where we are talking about solar irrigation and solar powered cold storage. So these are unique developments that are really, really important. Bio village initiative being taken up in Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. The major challenges to promote organic farming are the problems of policy support, inadequate quality standards, low crop rotation, inadequate market research, use of technology, contract farming. So those are some of the major issues that we face when we are talking about organic farming. So idea is to have a better management and a better sustainable development system for development of organic farming. Once the organic farming is developed, marketing becomes a prior thing. So talking about agrotourism, certification programs. So 29 organic certificate accreditation bodies have been authorized by EBDA in India. We are then focusing focusing on retailing, packaging, increasing the shelf life, participation in various shows and exhibitions. So those are some of the crucial things that we focus on. Now, biofertilizers and green manures are very important pillars of organic farming. Green manuring utilizes lean period between two main crops. So let's say wheat and rice. So between that two crops, you have green manuring that is emphasized. This aims at improving the crop and the soil fertility. Biofertilizers are very, very inexpensive, so can be widely used by farmers. They have no problems related to environmental pollution, so are friendly. We are also focusing on various types of biofertilizers. So here are some of the examples of biofertilizers. You would have those in the handouts. So you can just check those out. The main idea is all these are eco-friendly, environmentally sustainable, create no pollution, they are less expensive, and overall they reduce the amount of carbon content into the atmosphere, so they are environmentally friendly. Now, biofertilizers could be classified as either bacterial, algal or fungal. Now, algal could be nitrogen fixatious. Fungal could be either in the form of symbiotic or non-symbiotic. For example, mycorrhiza is one good example. Then you have numerous nitrogen fixatures which are either symbiotic, associative or non-symbiotic in nature. The next is the benefits. So benefits, as we said, you are trying to reduce the use of synthetic fertilizers, which are NPK fertilizers. They provide nutrient, the biofertilizers provide nutrient to the plant and protect the plant from diseases causing pathogens. It also suppresses the disease, promote the growth of hormones like auxin and glibrolic acid, which basically promote the growth of the plant. So those are some of the major advantages. Then sometimes they are used either in liquid formulations or they could be used in solid formulations. The idea of using liquid formulation is they can be stored for a longer period. They can be applied directly to the seed and the space required is pretty less for liquid storage. Then we are also talking about inoculants. We are focusing on the quality control. However, there are some restrictions or constraints which are seen by the government. Green manuring is very, very important. So what we practice is growing plants on the site. Once we are growing plants on the site, we are trying to turn the soil into a fresh soil, a soil with higher amount of nutrients that would be present. So there are various types of green manuring that is done with minimum nutrient and water requirement, and you have nitrogen fixation legumes which basically bind the soil. So that's very, very important. Now, green leaf manuring are grown mainly in the separate fields. You have dhanchia, which is grown after wheat harvest and before the rice plantation. Similarly, you are trying to grow numerous crops, which is intermittent to the two major crops, as we already discussed. This improves the physical structure of the soil. It helps to maintain the activity of the soil and the microorganism. The major disadvantage is the decomposition is not proper, mainly under the rain-fed conditions, and it could possibly lead to decomposition if the sowing is not done at a right time. However, over the years, we have seen the organic farming has been changing drastically. During the time of Rig Veda, you have Brihat Samhita, where we are talking about agricultural predictions, which were mainly in the form of rainfall, soil improvement that could be done, and promotion of better farm equipments that could be done. But organic farming without chemicals is basically after the power agriculture started, and we came into awareness that this is the second largest emitter of greenhouse gas. So we focused on moving to an organic farming approach where the carbon emissions could be significantly reduced. It's a much healthier option. We are trying to combat the problems of climate change, enhance the moisture retention in the field. So India has highest number of producers followed by Uganda and Mexico. So that's again very, very important. In terms of area, Australia leads the countries. So you have some of the statistics that are given here. Again, we have a changing role. So how the small farmers are also moving slowly and gradually towards organic farming is important to understand. You have Amrit Pani, Panchagavya. Those are some of the common mixtures that are being used. The system for rice intensification, requirement of seeds is only one, either 1/8 or the water is reduced to 20%. So that's again very, very important to understand here. We have numerous technological innovations coming up, mainly in the ideas of crop rotation, green manuring. We are trying to integrate this green manuring with the activities like crop husbandry, dairy, poultry farming. So we have nutrient management, which is very, very important. Before the introduction of HIV seeds, we were talking with the organic manures. Okay, so organic manure become very, very important. Weed management is again a very complicated issue. So how could you commercially tackle the issues of weed management through organic farming? How biopesticides could be used is again important. So manipulation of pH levels, adjustment of the seeding rate. We are talking about the field size biological method. So those are some of the important aspects. Then we are also talking about destruction of the alternate host plants, focusing on the pest resistant varieties. Mechanical methods have been important. So hand picking of caterpillars, putting the tin sheets around the coconut trees in order that rats do not damage the coconut plants. Similarly, we have trenching, which is for the larva of the red hairy caterpillar. You have certain applications which are very, very important. This could be a direct question in match list. So light trap for steam borer of rice. We have methyl eugenil trap for fruit flies. We have probe trap for adult insects. So those are the various techniques that have been used. The role of women have been very, very important. You have different case studies that we have mentioned from, let's say, Sundargarh in Odisha, where you have the idea of safe and nutritious food through organic farming. Similarly, you have Olivia women farmers who are growing 12 crops in a single season, each in one row, which is again very, very important. Jandhanya is an association of women farmer in Karnataka for protecting agro biodiversity. Very, very important part of your case studies. So these you can easily cite as case studies. You have group of farmers which are also in the Ramnagar district of Karnataka, which are focusing on processing and organic inputs. So these are some of the very classic examples, even for your exams like NABARD, where rural development is a major focus. Organic farming could be a very probable question. Health benefits definitely are important. Let's say in terms of antioxidants, the fruits and the vegetable grown have much higher amount of antioxidants. Similarly, the amount of sugars, the total soluble sugars, the ascorbic acid content in the case of pomegranate have been registered much higher through the integrated nutrient management system. You have higher amount of protein and sulfur containing amino acids which are seen. Organic livestock production shows higher welfare even for the animals. And the idea, as we said, is to mitigate the problem of climate change through the idea of carbon sequestration in the soil by using more organic manure and avoiding any kind of synthetic fertilizers. So NABARD, as I already said, for the NABARD exam, it's very, very important. So how NABARD is important for organic farming? We are focusing on low input farming in the new socially acceptable terms of organic farming. So natural capital is what is in the mind. We are focusing on how cultivation practices through organic farming could bring in eco-friendly technologies. Capital investment subsidy schemes are being focused. So National Center of Organic Farming works in collaboration with NABARD. And the idea is to promote organic farming to increase the agricultural productivity and bring in environmental safety. So those are some of the major points that we have discussed in this lecture. We'll be bringing up many more series of Kurukshetra, highly important for your mains answer writing section. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.